This is my 2020 Intel-based MacBook Pro running Windows 11 in high-performance mode. And as you can see, it looks fantastic, and even the touch bar controls are fully functional. In this video, I will show you how to dual boot macOS and Windows 11 on your Mac in just a few minutes. This step-by-step installation guide will help you run Windows 11 natively on Intel-based Macs. This guide is only for Intel Macs. If your Mac is powered by Apple Silicon, check out the video link in the description for more information. Now, with that said, let's get started. Before installing Windows 11 alongside macOS on your Intel Mac using Bootcamp Assistant, there are a few things to note. Unlike Windows 10, Apple stopped supporting Windows 11 in Bootcamp Assistant. So when you try to import the Windows 11 ISO file into the Bootcamp Assistant, it will throw an error. Now, this happens due to the Windows 11 hardware requirements. However, there's a trick. We first install Windows 10 using Bootcamp and then upgrade it to Windows 11. That being said, for this demonstration, I will use my MacBook Pro 2020 running macOS Sonoma, which features a T2 security chip. To dual boot macOS with Windows 11, make sure your Mac has at least 100 GB of free space. Now let's download the required ISO files. First, download Windows 11 ISO file by visiting this link. Once it's downloaded, head over to this link to download the Windows 11 ISO file. After downloading both ISO files, store them somewhere accessible for easier to use. Then you will need a USB drive with at least 8 GB of storage, connect it to your Mac and open Disk Utility. Now select your USB drive from the sidebar. Click Erase and name it. Now choose the exFAT file system for formatting. Once formatted, copy the Windows 11 ISO file to the USB drive. Once it's done, eject the USB drive and set it aside for later use. Now go ahead and open the Bootcamp Assistant and make sure your Mac is connected to a power source. Then shrink the free space on your Mac for Windows installation. Now for this, I recommend allocating around 100 GB, but make sure it's not less than 70 GB. Then import the Windows 10 ISO file into the Bootcamp Assistant. Then click Install and let the Bootcamp download the required drivers. Ensure you have a stable and fast internet connection during this process. After the drivers are downloaded, your Mac will automatically boot into Windows 10 setup. Now follow the on-screen instructions to install Windows 10. Select your language, time, and keyboard layout, then click Next. If you have a license key, enter it. Otherwise, select I don't have a product key. Then choose Windows Edition you want to install. I recommend Windows Professional. Accept the terms and conditions and proceed. The installation will take some time, so sit back and be patient. Once Windows 10 is installed, follow the on-screen instructions to complete the setup. After completing the Windows 10 setup, the Bootcamp installer will appear. You can connect to Wi-Fi if needed, but for now, I leave it to disabled. Then open Control Panel. Search for UAC and click on User Account Control Settings and set it to Never Notify to avoid interruptions. Now follow the on-screen instructions to install the Bootcamp drivers. This process may take some time, so avoid interrupting it. If your Mac gets stuck, force turn off by holding the power button, then restart the Mac and rerun the Bootcamp setup, which you will find in the OS Reset partition to complete the driver installation. Once drivers are installed, your Mac will reboot automatically. This process resolves issues related to graphics, the touchpad, sound, display, and much more. For instance, on my MacBook, the touch bar functions perfectly, allowing me to adjust the brightness, audio, and keyboard backlighting seamlessly. Next, open the Bootcamp control panel using the quick link. Here, you can manage your startup disk. If Windows is selected, your Mac will boot into Windows by default upon restart. Also, enable options like tap to click under trackpad settings to simulate clicks without pressing down physically. Then click OK to save the changes. And that's it, we have finished setting up Windows 10. It's time to upgrade to Windows 11. This is very important, so you might need to watch this part a couple of times to ensure everything works properly. So pay attention while upgrading to Windows 11. Now, upgrading to Windows 11 requires bypassing hardware requirements like Secure Boot and TPM 2.0, which most Macs lack. This MacBook with Intel i7 10th generation supports Windows 11 but lacks a TPM chip, so we will bypass these requirements. Now go ahead and connect the USB drive containing the Windows 11 ISO to your Mac and copy the ISO file to your system. Then eject the USB drive after the transfer is complete. For demonstration purposes, I will connect my Bluetooth mouse and keyboard. Before starting the upgrade, we need to run a command to resolve potential upgrade issues. Now open command prompt as administrator and enter the required command. Now this step cleans up leftover device drivers and registry entries, ensuring a smooth upgrade. Then right-click the Windows 11 ISO file. Choose Open With and select Windows Explorer to mount the Windows 11 ISO. Now go ahead and note down the mount path, which in my case is F. Then open the command prompt as administrator and navigate to the installation files and press Enter. In the command prompt, change the letter F for the letter that corresponds to your drive. Then type the following command to run Windows 11 setup, bypassing hardware requirements, and press Enter. An upgrade window will appear labeled as Windows Server. Don't worry, this is normal. Then click Change How Windows Setup Download Updates, select Not Right Now, and proceed. then accept the terms and choose to keep all files, settings, and applications, and click Next. I will disconnect my Bluetooth mouse and keyboard from the Mac and ensure no USB devices are connected during the upgrade except for the power cord. Once you complete the steps, the setup will proceed to upgrade to the latest version of Windows 11 24H2. However, Windows 11 will run in unsupported state, meaning it won't guarantee updates or receive support from Microsoft. Additionally, the setup will now be labeled as Windows Server, but it will install the client version of the operating system. The process should take around 20 to 30 minutes, so please be patient. Congratulations, Windows 11 should now run smoothly on your Mac. It will detect the built-in GPU and function well. To enhance Windows 11 performance, it's recommended to adjust the power settings. To do so, open the control panel and search for power options, then choose a power plan and click Create a new plan. Select High Performance, name the profile and click Next. This will allow the CPU to run at higher clock speeds, resulting in optimal performance. Now, as you can see, the touch bar on my Mac is also functioning properly without any issues. Now, to switch back to macOS, open the Bootcamp control panel in Windows and select Restart to macOS. In macOS, open Startup Disk and choose Windows 11 or macOS as the default OS you want to use to start up your computer. You can also use Boot Menu to switch between Windows 11 and macOS. To do this, restart your Mac from either Windows 11 or macOS, then press and hold the Option key until the Boot Menu appears. From here, you can select either macOS or Windows 11. Now choose Macintosh to boot into macOS or Windows to boot into Windows 11. As a bonus part of this video, if you decide to remove Windows 11 and use macOS exclusively, first boot back into macOS. Open Startup Disk and set macOS as the default OS. Then open Bootcamp Assistant, click Continue, and select Restore to remove the Windows partition. This will restore the free space back to macOS. And that's it. This is how you properly set up a dual boot configuration with Windows 11 and macOS on your Mac. Let me know what you think in the comment section down below. Thank you so much for watching. This has been KSK Royal. I will see you in the next one.